Hey everybody, today we're talking about how menopause affects your body. I'm Dr. Perkins, I'm a board certified OBGYN, and I love having conversations with you about this and many more. Join us. Menopause affects so many different parts of us. In this video today, we'll talk about the impact of menopause on your spirit, your emotions, and your physical body. So, what is menopause? Menopause is that time in a female's life where her world kind of changes. Menopause really is a day in your life. It is one specific time. Let's explain. Between puberty, which often happens now in females around 9 or 10 years old, to about 40 years old in the average person, a woman would be ovulating, producing a mature egg every single month, waiting in hopes to get pregnant. The egg dies, periods come, and then the cycle goes over and over back to back every single month. Around the mid 40s, a woman may start to have changes to her body that signifies transitioning to the menopause or going into the perimenopause state. At this time, you may notice that your periods are more irregular, the length of your periods may change, how often they occur may change, and the intensity of your periods may change as well. During this time, there may be a yo-yo effect between the major hormones of the female reproductive system. Those are the estrogens and the progesterones. In a normal cycle, estrogens would be released in the first half of the cycle, and in the second half, progesterones would be released. Both hormones are very important to really yo-yo back and forth and maintain the reproductive system. As a person is going through perimenopause or getting ready to go through menopause, these levels start to decrease, and the impact on the body is pretty great. By definition, means that you've gone 12 consecutive months with no periods at all. And this is in the absence of having medications such as birth control or any type of hormonal medication or treatments like cancer treatments that may impact your ovulation and your fertility. At this point in time, when 12 missed periods have been noted, you are now in menopause. After that day has passed, you are now postmenopausal. Until the point of menopause, this roller coaster of having imbalances in your estrogens and your progesterone really continues for up to 10 years. Now, there's so many different symptoms that may be felt or experienced during this time, and we're about to talk about these now. As you're experiencing these changes during perimenopause, the time frame leading up to menopause, or postmenopause, your reproductive system may be affected, your immune system, your nervous system, your cardiovascular system, and in fact, every single organ system in your body will notice that you're going through menopause. The most common symptoms of menopause include a combination that we call vasomotor symptoms, or VMS. This is a combination of having hot flashes, which is an intense period of time that lasts sometimes about a minute to 2 minutes. And in this time frame, you get extremely hot. And then shortly after, you get extremely cold. It also incorporates having night sweats. And by night sweats, we're not referring to having some sweating at night that is just pretty light and pretty mild. We're talking about drenched sweating. This means that your pillowcases are soaked, your sheets are soaked, everything is soaked from all the sweating. And this can occur multiple times during the night or through the entire duration of your sleep. As you enter menopause, you may really start noticing that other things are happening outside of the night sweats and the hot flashes. For instance, weight gain is very, very common. What happens during this time is that you start to build up on a lot of abdominal fat right around your organs and in your midsection. And this is because there is a transition between the types of fat that your body holds after menopause. This is due to estrogens no longer being in your system. In general, while estrogens can be bad for so many different reasons, primarily that they cause a lot of cancers surrounding the female system, from the breast to the uterus to the ovaries. However, estrogens are very protective. It's a beautiful thing. You really want those estrogens to be there and enjoy them while they're there, because once they're gone there, it can be felt that they're no longer there. But with the estrogens, they protect your organs, your cells, your system all together in a way that helps you to prevent getting other chronic diseases that can be pretty dangerous. With estrogens and your fat cells, when you go through postmenopause, your fat cells move from your peripheral, meaning that your hands or your feet area, and those cells literally transition to your abdominal area. Now, it takes specific, targeted work to help to reduce the amount of fat cells that are building up around your abdomen. You can absolutely do this, but changing your diet and your lifestyle is imperative to be able to do this. During this time, as that fat transitioning is happening, what's also happening is that you're losing muscle mass. If you're losing muscle mass, the ability to burn additional calories and to be able to maintain your skeletal system reduces over time. Because of that, you are also exposed to having lower bone density or experiencing osteopenia or osteoporosis. If you enjoy our conversation today, go ahead and click subscribe to this channel. Let's talk about a few more changes that you may experience in menopause. Anxiety and depression may increase tremendously. This is because your serotonin levels, in addition to the estrogens and the progesterones, they're decreasing dramatically and in a way that causes your neurotransmitters in your brain to be so imbalanced that anxiety and depression may happen. Now, some people may experience this for the very first time in their lives. And if that's the case, understand that this is due to your hormones fluctuating so drastically. Vaginal dryness is another hallmark sign of menopause. Estrogens are needed to maintain the elasticity and the consistency of your skin in the vagina and in the vulva as well. When your estrogens go down, essentially the entire area down there becomes very dry, and sometimes getting some additional estrogens from your doctor just in the vaginal area may help you overcome this dryness. This dryness may also lead to you having pain with sexual activity to the point that it becomes so uncomfortable that your libido goes down and you have no desire for sex anymore. In addition to having some estrogens in the area locally to help with this, lubrication is also a great option to help to relieve the symptoms of vaginal dryness. Another very, very common symptom is having less sleep or difficulty sleeping, insomnia of some kind. And in fact, the amount of sleep that is recommended for someone in menopause is 1 hour shorter than the average female. So in general, you may hear the recommendation of having 8 to 9 hours of sleep per night, especially as a female, to be able to reset and balance your hormones. In menopause, really, the recommendation is at least 7, because we know that because of the constant fluctuation of your hormones and waking up multiple times a night due to hot flashes or night sweats, we know that your sleep is often disrupted, but the amount of sleep to be normal or to feel normal is reduced by about an hour to an average 7 hours. Having brain fog or memory loss during menopause is also very, very common. Again, this is linked with you having such imbalances with your estrogens and your progesterones. Lastly, many, many people may experience incontinence as you go through menopause. Again, this is due to our estrogens and our progesterones going down. Once those estrogens are no longer in your system, they're not keeping the integrity of your cells and your organs down there. Urinary loss can happen because the urethra has changed, as well as your bladder. You may also have incontinence fecally, wherein the cells of your anus and your rectum are being affected by estrogens as well. You may also have, linked with both of these, could also be pelvic floor prolapse, which is an overall weakening of all the ligaments and the organs in that reproductive pelvic area. And once that weakness occurs, everything starts to fall, becomes a little bit softer, kind of changes position in your pelvis, and this affects the function of your bladder and the function of your rectum, affecting your ability to hold everything inside as well as you did prior to menopause. Today, I'd like to offer you a very free gift. Free, free, free. Go to the link in my bio to get a free copy of my hormone balancing ebook, Hormones Don't Lie. In this book, you'll learn so many strategies regarding how to help your hormones be their best. Thank you so much for being in this conversation today. It's been a pleasure. See you next time.